Hello dear students, welcome to the mathematics online class. And today also I'm gonna teach you the continue exercise, and we're gonna continue the exercise 19.3 today. So the first question you can see here is that use the rule 1 and write the value of x in the blank. So use the rule 1 means rule 1. Now we need to know that what does the rule 1 mean. I have already explained in my previous video, but although if you don't have the idea about it, then you can go through the video and know about it. So the first thing that we need to know is about the rule 1. The rules, so rule 1, rule 2, we have a rule 3 and rule 4. Right, so the rule first is about the addition. Rule 2 is subtraction. Rule 3 is multiplication. And rule 4 is division. Okay, so since the first question, okay, if you see, if you have the book, then you can see the first question is like, this you can see here, if x minus 4 equals to 8, then the find the value of x. Suppose if x minus 4 equals to 8, then we have to find the value of x here. So what is the what will be the value of x here? And here it is saying to use the rule 1. So using rule 1, x minus 4, it will be same. Rule 1 means, rule 1 always said there should be the addition. Addition of what? The digit which is near the alphabet. The digit which is near the value of the alphabet that we need to find out. So we need to do the addition. So we'll be doing the plus 4 here. Equals to 8 plus 4. Why we are doing plus 4 here? Let's check whether if we do this plus 4, then there will be any changes in the question or not. Let's check, okay? If we check, like x minus 4 plus 4 equals to 8 plus 4. X minus 4 equals to 8 plus 4, and when this 4 is shifted to another side, then it will be minus 4. Since plus 4 and minus 4 will be cancelled out, so the remaining equation will be the same. So there is no any changes if we do the plus addition in both hand side. Why we are doing it? We are doing it so that we are making the we are to find out the value of x by making LHS equals to RHS. That means the left hand side of the equation must be equal to the right hand side. So x and this plus 4, minus 4 and plus 4 will be cancelled out. So x will be remaining and will be equal to 8 plus 4, that is 12. So this is the value of x. So this is question number 1A. So like this you will be doing above rule 1. So if there is rule 2, then you can do of subtraction. Subtraction means you have to add like minus 4. If there is a saying, if the question has asked you to do the subtraction, then you have to do the minus. If the if the question has said about the multiplication or the using the rule 3, okay, suppose here the question we have in question number 3 we have rule 3. So using rule 3 we need to find out the value of this z by 5 equals to 1. So let's find out this. Here given z by 5 equals to 1, question number 3a, okay, question number 3a. So z by 5 equals to 1 is given. Now we need to find out the value of z. For finding out the value of z, using rule 3, z by 5 equals to 1. I'm placing here a gap. Rule 3 means multiplication. You can see here we have written rule 3 means multiplication. Multiplying what? Multiplying with the number which is nearer to, which is in the side of the alphabet given, that we need to find out the value of. So we have z by 5 here. So we'll be multiplying by 5 on both hand side. Let's do this. And this 5 in the denominator and this 5 in the numerator will be cancelled out. Z width will remaining, and 1 into 5 is equals to 5 only. So the value is 5. Like this, you will be doing the rule 3. Let's check of rule 4. That is 4a question. We have given. So given is 4a equals to 12 is given. Using rule, you have to write this all, okay? Rule 4. Now, using rule 4. Rule 4 means division. Rule 4 means division. So now, we have to divide with the value, with the digit which is the, nearer to the alphabet given, right? So we have 4 in the nearer alphabet. So 4A is there, 12 is there. Now, since the using rule 4 is the division method, now we'll be dividing by 4 on the both hand side. Dividing by 4 on both hand side, numerator and denominator having same number will be cancelled out, and we'll be writing R. R A equals to 4. How many is 12? 4. 3 is 12. So the answer is 3. Okay, like this you can do all the questions of question number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now we have the different question about question number 5. Question number 5 I have already explained you. So let's do question number 7 then. In question number 7, solve for M is given. So if the question asks you solve for A, solve for B, solve for M, so there won't be any differences, okay? That one is the alphabet and you need to find out the value of it only. So there won't be any differences if there will be asked about solving the value of A or find the value of X or find the value of M. So there won't be any difference. That is the value that we need to find out only. We need to understand that. Okay, in 7A, so we have, let's do question number 7B, okay? 7A is a bit easier. 15 minus 3M minus 4 equals to minus 2 is given. If you check the question, then the question is like this. Now we need to find out the value of M. Okay, for finding out the value of M, let's first make it in a simpler form. This bracket is given, right? So let's open the bracket first. Since here is a minus, so minus into plus 3 becomes minus 3M. Minus into minus becomes plus, and the 4 will be 4 only, so minus 2. Now what I'll be doing is that I'll be placing the alphabetical order, alphabetical value in one side, that is in LHS, and I'll be keeping the numerical value in right hand side. You understand? Right hand side is this one. Suppose here will be right hand side, here will be left hand side. So the in left hand side, I am saying that I will be just placing the alphabetical value. And in the right hand side, I'll be placing the numerical value. So the numerical value, minus 2 will be same here. When this plus 4 will go in another side, it will be minus 4. When this plus 15 will go in another side, there will be minus 15. Or minus 3m will be the same. And let's now find out what will be the value of it. Minus 2, minus 4 will be minus 6. And minus 6, minus 15 will be minus 21. Okay, so now minus 3m is remaining, right? So what you need to understand is that minus 3m, here is the multiplication sign. Here is nothing, means in between this there is a multiplication. So when the multiplication sign will go in another side, then it will be division. Yes. So, m equals to minus 21 upon minus 3. This minus minus will be cancelled out, and 3, 7 is 21, or m equals to 7. The value of m is 7. Like that, let's do another question in, okay, so another question will be like of J number. In J number, we have 10 m minus 1 plus 8 equals to 9m minus 1. Okay, 10m minus 1 plus 8, 9m minus 1. So how to solve this now? Now we'll be opening the bracket. Since the 10 is here, so we will directly multiply 10 into m, or 10 into m will be 10m. 10 into minus 1 will be minus 10, plus 8 will be same, and 9m and minus 1 will be same. Again, in left hand side and right hand side, I will differentiate, I will classify the variables. Since the variable is given here 10m and 9m, I'll keep that variable in one side and numerical part in another side. Like 10m will be here. When this 9m will be shifted towards another side, then it will be minus 9m. Now, minus 1 will be same. And now the numerical value of this. Minus 10 when shifted here, it will be plus 10. Plus 8 when shifted here, it will be minus 8. Okay. So what is the remaining here? 10m minus 9m is equals to 1m, or you can simply write m only. And minus 8 and minus 1 and minus 8 will become minus 9 plus 10 is there, right? Or so let's write only m. So minus 9 plus 10 will be plus sign is greater, so it will be plus and the difference is 1. So the value of m is m equals to 1. Okay, like this you can do question number Z. Similarly, we have question number, okay, let's do question number M then. So in question number M, we have 4M plus 3 equals to 5 by 2, M minus 2 is there. So this is the question. 4M plus 3 equals to 5 by 2, m minus 2. So this is the question, right? So now we need to know that in when there is a bracket and the digit is given, in both of these cases, so in both of these cases there is a multiplication in between these. So multiplication, that means when we have to shift any of the part, then it will be it will be of division. Since here 2 is in the denominator part, when it goes in the another side, it will be in the numerator part. Yes, how? This is in the division, this is dividing 5, right? So 2, when it is in the numerator, denominator part in this side, when it goes in the another side, it will be in the numerator part by multiplying. So how it will multiply? 2 into 4m plus 3 equals to 5 will be same, and minus 2 will also be same. There will be no any changes. Only this 2, when it is shifted in another side, it will multiply. So or 2 into 4 equals to 8, m plus 3 equals to 5. Okay, let's open this. 5 into m, 5m. 5 into minus 2, minus 10. So like this. Let's open this also. 8m plus 8, 3 is a 24 equals to 5m minus 10. Okay, minus 10. Okay, let's do this here only. Okay, so here or now arranging in the left hand side and right hand side. Okay, in the left hand side there will be 8m and this, when this 5 will shift to the another side, it will be minus 5m. Similarly, now we have minus 10 here, and when this plus 24 will shift in another side, it will be minus 24. So now what is the remaining here? 8m minus 5m will be 3m. And minus 10 minus 24 will be minus 34. Or m equals to, since here is a multiplication, minus 34 open, there will be 3. It will go in another side for and it will divide. So minus 34 open 3 will be the answer. So this is your answer. Okay, like this you can do all the questions of 7 also. Thank you so much, everyone.